Obeying the Gospel, May 7th. The hand that made us is divine. For what can be known about God is plain to them, because God has shown it to them. For His invisible attributes, namely His eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly perceived ever since the creation of the world in the things that have been made. Romans 1, 19 and 20. Have you ever heard the expression preponderance of the evidence? It's a cumbersome string of words, I'll grant you, but it contains a useful idea. The preponderance of the evidence means the greater weight of evidence. Disputed questions are, or should be, settled this way. When all the evidence has been heard and all the arguments made, on which side does the evidence weigh more heavily? In which direction do the scales tip? The existence of God is a disputed question, to say the least. And it seems that disbelief is the trending position right now. Yet the evidence has not changed. It is what it has always been. And no matter what the social, cultural, and political pressures may be, our task also remains unchanged. We must decide whether the evidence is heavier on the side of belief or disbelief. Now, it is one thing to sit safely in Starbucks and debate the existence of God. But what if your life depended on it? Suppose you were going to be asked whether God exists, an envelope would be opened revealing the truth of the matter. May I have the envelope, please? And if your answer was wrong, you would be taken outside and shot to death. What would you do? You would ignore the opinion polls and hang your hopes on whichever position had the greater evidence. With your life on the line, you would disregard even your own prejudices. Only one thing would matter, the evidence. Paul argued that God's eternal power and divine nature are clearly seen in the things that have been made. Many have agreed, including Joseph Addison, who was no fool when he wrote, "The hand that made us is divine." It is reason, based on thoughtful observation and not childish simplicity, that urges this conclusion. In the familiar words of Addison's poetry, "What though in solemn silence all move round the dark terrestrial ball? What though nor real voice nor sound amid their radiant orbs be found? In reason's ear they all rejoice and utter forth a glorious voice, forever singing as they shine, the hand that made us is divine."